Welcome all. Welcome back to the Learning Hibernate series. This is lecture 4. And I hope you people are safe at your home and also practicing the concepts. Fine, so let's okay, so let's start with Hibernate generator classes. Although we have almost finished this topic, but there were some queries about Hibernate generate classes, so that's why I have added this particular topic also into our slide, and I'll show you what are Hibernate generator classes. Okay. So basically, these Hibernate generator classes are used to generate the identifiers. Now, identifiers have very much important meaning in both Java objects and also in our tables. Yes. So in tables, the identifiers are primary keys, whereas over here the identifiers are the variables of the class which will be used as unique identifiers. So basically, while saving an object into the database, what this generator classes do is they help us to generate specific identifiers. It will inform, this generator class will inform the Hibernate that how the primary key value is to be generated. You may make it as if you want to generate it by incrementing by 2. Yes, you can make it like that. You may want to increment it by 5 or some other algorithm. Yes, you can make it. You want to generate your custom defined identifier, that is primary key, custom defined primary key. Yes, you can do that. So all these things are possible using Hibernate generator classes. Now, Hibernate uses different primary key generator algorithms. We will see all of those today, and we'll not go deep into that, but we'll have a introduction of all. Okay, and I'll show you today how to convert your simple desktop-based application into web-based application. We have till date we have seen 3 to 4 desktop-based Hibernate applications. So the same applications, I will show you how to convert it into web-based applications. Okay, so basically, for each algorithm that this generator classes use internally, a class is defined by the Hibernate for its implementation. And if it is a user-defined generator, then the user has to provide its own class implementation. Okay, so this is what is an ID, that is the generator class. This is what is an ID in the XML file, that is the Hibernate mapping file. Here this ID refers to the column that will be used as an ID, and generator class is nothing but a sub element of ID. And to generate unique identifiers for the objects that we want to persist into the database, this generator class is used. And we can also implement our own. Basically, this generator class that Hibernate provides is implementing the identifier generator interface provided by Hibernate. And yes, we may create our own generator class by simply implementing this identifier generator interface. We will not go deeper into that. That is itself a big topic on how to make your own identifier generator class. So basically, framework provides many inbuilt generator classes. We already seen these are the generator classes that are provided by the Hibernate out of which assigned increment. These are some of the basic that we use regularly. Let's see all of them one by one, and then I will show you which we are using in our applications, and then I will also show you in the end how to convert that desktop based applications into web based applications. So then our Hibernate topic will be completed. Okay, let's go with assigned. This assigned basically is a default generator strategy if there is no generator element, and here the application has to assign the ID. That is, we as a programmer have to add the ID and we have to insert it into the database. It is supported by all the databases, so we can use it with any database. And default generator class, yes, it's a default generator class. So if no generator element is specified inside the ID element, then it is always assigned. That is, Hibernate assumes that it has been assigned by the programmer, so it does not have to worry about generating a specific ID. Yes, so programmer is responsible in that case of assigning the primary key value to the object, which is to be saved into the database. Then comes, let's take an example. See, this is how we use it. Generator class equal to assigned. Okay, in ID we use this generator class equal to assigned, and if it is not there, no generator, this, if this part is not there, this generator part is not there, then by default this is the generator class that is being used by Hibernate. That is, it assumes that the programmer has assigned the ID manually inside the program itself. Then comes the increment. Increment is where it generates the ID for every new record by using a formula. Now that formula is something like this: maximum of ID value in the database plus 1. So whatever will be the maximum value of the ID right now in the database, that will be added by 1, and that new value will be given as the ID of the object to be inserted in the database. Yes, it is for the new object that is yet to be inserted into the database. It supports all the databases because auto increment facility is provided in almost all the databases nowadays, so it supports all the databases. And yes, it is database independent, so each and every database creates its own auto increment algorithm, but still this is database independent. You don't need to worry about it. Java programmer, application programmer does not need to worry about it. And if there is no record initially in the database, then for the first time what it will do is it will take the maximum ID as 0 and then 0 plus 1, and so it starts with 1. And it, yes, what it gives is in return it replies. You might have seen in our last previous sessions that when we save an object, it returns some value. And what is that value? That value is the ID value that is been assigned by the Hibernate or the database. So when it returns it as a data type of short or int or long type. So you might have seen we have taken it into integer variable. If you manually assign for primary key for an object, then Hibernate doesn't consider that value and uses this maximum value. So in increment case, if we have manually assigned by default, by mistake, then it does not consider that, and it still uses the concept of maximum ID plus 1. So auto increment ignores the value that we have provided. Make sure that is to be taken care of. And if a table contains an identifier, then the application considers it to be maximum value. So if there is already an identifier or stored inside the table, that is already a record with a primary key value, having some identifier value, then it considers that to be the maximum, and it then generates the new value as that maximum value plus 1, or else if there is no record, then it considers the first value to be 1. So it just increments the identifier by 1 in any of the case, that is either 0 plus 1 or the old maximum value plus 1. This is the syntax, similar to all other. Only thing is the class name will change. Class here instead of assigned becomes increment. Then comes the sequence. The sequence is basically for inserting whenever we insert. See, all these classes are for inserting new records into in a database, but the sequence is special type. It uses the sequence of the database. Yes. And the thing is, the sequence data type is not supported by all the databases, right? So we have to take care. What does it do is, it first gets the next value from the sequence in the database. So it first thing is, it interacts whenever we create an object. What does it first do is, it interacts with the database first, gets the sequence and gets the next value from that sequence to be assigned to that new object created whenever that object has to be saved. So it assigns that value to the new record, and if no sequence is defined, it will automatically create a sequence. So that is the facility that is provided, that if the database designer has not designed any sequence object inside the database, then the Cybernet will generate it automatically. It will create a new sequence object and it will also store it inside the database. So mostly in Oracle we use sequences, and if it is not there, we have not created, the database designer has not created any sequence, then it creates a sequence named Hibernate underscore sequence and then assigns numbers to it one by one. Okay, so now what is sequence? Just you can check, you can revise your concepts of sequence by going into your database concepts of third semester. Try to search on net what is a sequence, try to see that. Sequences as such, right now we do not require sequences, but in industries these can be used for different purposes. Now let's see another. Yes, for other databases like DB2, SAP, it uses sequence, but it uses generator and interbase. So so these are the different types of databases which are supported. You can see here obviously MySQL is not supported because it is not supported in MySQL. Okay, sorry for that. Yes, here it is. So yes, sequence, the sequence object is not there in MySQL, so you cannot use this generator class if you are using the database as MySQL. Again, you saw in this example it is database dependent. The first two that we saw, where that is the assigned generator class and increment generator class, these two are database independent, but this particular generator class is database dependent. You cannot use this generator class for all the databases, that is the main thing, and we need to know what is the database and whether the database supports the sequence object or not. So a programmer has to create a sequence in the database before the application interacts with the database, and that sequence should be named, should be passed as the generator as a parameter. So we'll see it later in the next slide. How it is passed as a parameter, and if, let's suppose if programmer has not passed any sequence name, then what Hibernate does is it, yes, we have seen it before, that it it creates its own sequence with Hibernate dash sequence name. It then gets next value from that sequence and assigns that ID as new record. And yes, for that thing to happen, what you have to take care is, in Hibernate configuration file, this property must be set. HBM to DDL.auto property must be enabled. If this is enabled, then only we'll be able to create the sequence on its own. Then only the Hibernate will be able to create the sequence inside the database and get a sequence object from it and assign it to the record. So we will have to take care. This is the syntax. You can see in here in this yes, you can see in ID the generator is there, okay, and in generator I'm sorry, you have not given the class name over here. The class name has to provide it in generator, and then the param name is there. There is something called as param. Now this param was not there in the two generators before, but here we require param name because that name will be used as a parameter to add the ID by using the sequence. So it will be something like my sequence 1, my sequence 2, my sequence 3. In that way, or this my sequence basically represents the name of the sequence object that is defined in the database, right? And that sequence might have been programmed in any way that you want. Okay, fine. So that is about sequence generator class. Now see, there is another generator class called native. It basically uses either identity or sequence or Hilo classes depending on the database vendor. So it first checks whether the database supports identity or not, and it supports identity. Basically it uses identity first. If identity is not there, then it checks for sequence, and if sequence is not there, then it checks for Hilo. Now if so, this is the sequence, this is the sequence in which it checks whether the identity type of generators class is supported by the database. If not, then it checks for sequence. If sequence type of data if sequence type of generator object is supported, then it checks for sequence, that is if database has sequence objects inside it. And if not, then it checks for Hilo. If database supports generating through Hilo algorithm, then it uses that. So for example, if we are connecting with Oracle, then we can use generator class as native. And then what does it do is it is equal to the generator class sequence. Sequence is supported in Oracle, and this is how we write it: generator class equal to native. Okay. Okay. Then let's say identity. Identity, yes, we saw that identity is being used in native, right? So it checks whether the native class checks whether the identity is supported by database, or the sequence is supported, or the Hilo is supported. In this one by one manners, or in this sequence, it checks. So what is identity? Let's say what is an identity generator class. Basically it is used by these particular databases like MySQL, Sybase, MySQL, MS SQL Server, DB2, right? These support the ID column in type of identity. Now, and yes, it can define it using this type of data types, that is short, int, or long. And it is the responsibility of the database to generate unique identifiers. So here the programmer does not need to worry about generating it, right? It is the responsibility of the database to generate this particular ID, and it will generate in this particular data type, short, int, or long, and also return it to the application. And yes, this is database dependent. So as you saw, there are database names over here. Whenever database names come into description, you always assume that those generator classes are database dependent. Yes, identity does not work with Oracle DB. and it doesn't need to pass any parameters, right? Like in sequence, we needed to pass the parameter as sequence name. Here in identity, there is no need to pass any parameter. And identity is somewhat similar to increment generator. ID value is generated by database and not by the Hibernate. So the database returns the new ID value generated. And for incrementing, Hibernate will take over this. So a new ID value is given by the database. The first ID value, whenever a new record is created, that particular first ID value will be generated by the database. But whenever, as you go on incrementing by adding new objects, that incrementing part will be taken over by the Hibernate. So that is the basic difference between the increment generator class and the identity generator class. Okay, so increment generator is database independent, that we saw, right? But this identity generator is database dependent. That is also a second biggest difference between identity generator class and increment generator class. Okay, increment generator class uses simple auto increment method of any database. This also uses the same identity, but that incrementing part will be taken over by the Hibernate. Database does not need to worry about it. So that is a basic difference. And yes, this is database dependent, that was database independent. So these two differences are there between identity and increment generator classes. Also, Hibernate selects uses select operation for selecting maximum ID before inserting a new record. So you see, to save a new object, there is always a select verified. So this is somewhat costlier also in terms of database connection and in terms of queries. But yes, this is how it works. It first selects the maximum ID, and then accordingly the Hibernate increments the new value, and it provides the new value to the object being stored or saved inside the database. So here what happens is, in identity, no selection operation is generated. Yes, so in increment operation, every time select operation is fired to get the latest maximum ID, here select operation here select an operation will not be generated. That is the basic, again, third difference between increment and identity generators. Okay, so it is to insert. So whenever we insert a new record, what it does is it simply assigns new ID according to its algorithm. Okay, so identity and increment are somewhat similar, but here I have tried to provide as much as possible differences so that you can remember both. Okay, then comes Hilo. So we saw what is a sequence, we also saw what is an identity, and we are seeing Hilo. These three are being used whenever we use the generator class as native. So native checks whether any one of these is supported by the underlying database, and if yes, in that particular sequence, whichever comes first, it uses that generator class algorithm to generate the IDs. So now what is Hilo? Hilo is basically database independent, and it uses high and low algorithm to generate the ID. So it would be something like the next high or the next low. To get next high every time, let's say if it is integer, then it may be 32767, then 32766. In that way, it will get the new next high, and that will be assigned. Okay, and it may be of type short, int, and long. So syntax is something like this: generator class Hilo. Okay, fine. Then comes sequence Hilo and UUID. Basically, the sequence using Hilo uses high and low algorithm on the specified sequence. So it uses both Hilo and sequence, a combination of both, and the data type that is returned is short, int, or long. Now this, what is UUID? This UUID is it uses 128-bit algorithm to generate the ID, okay, and it's unique user ID, okay, and the return data type is of string, that is unique within a network, because IP is being used to generate it, and it is also represented in hexadecimal digits, that is 32 in length. Fine. So this UUID has specific applications. It is mostly used in data types where, or in applications where mapping applications are there. In those kind of applications, UUID is used many a times. GUID is also somewhat similar to that, basically, but it is used in MS SQL Server and MySQL Server, so it is database dependent, okay. Then comes, and yes, MS SQL Server has its own algorithms to generate GUID, and these GUIDs are very much unique, okay. So the user does not have to worry, the application programmer does not have to worry about identifying each and every object uniquely, or to identify which algorithm to use to uniquely identify each object. So the programmer is relieved from that particular responsibility with the help of this GUID. Then comes select. It uses the primary key returned by the database trigger. Now the triggers are supported in very less databases like Oracle, okay, so that is also database specific. Then comes foreign. Now this foreign is used when we will be using the foreign keys and associations, okay, one to one or one to many associations, in those kind of things we will be using this foreign, okay. And sequence identity, basically it's a special sequence generation strategy and supported in Oracle 10g drivers only right now. So these are the various generator classes that we are using, okay. So that's it, that's end of the Hibernate unit, and I will also show you, along with this I will also show you how to convert our application into a web application, desktop based application into a web application, okay. So check this out, this Hibernate app 1 was our first app that we had created. Now what was there in that, let's check. See, there are two XML files, one is Hibernate mapping XML file for employee, another is Hibernate configuration file. Then comes the employee, this Pojo class, this employee.java. Then comes manageEmployee.java, which is responsible for adding that employee object, that is for creating that employee object, populating it and saving it to the database. So that work is done by manageEmployee. So let's go in this sequence. First let's check hibernate.configuration file. In this hibernate configuration file, you will see the dialect property, you will see the driver class name property, the connection URL, username and password. These properties are being defined, and also mapping resource. Don't forget to add this mapping resource, this mapping tag. If you forget this, you will not get the employee class. You will not be able to, Hibernate will not be able to map the employee class onto a particular employee table. Remember this thing. Then comes the employee.java file, which is Pojo class. It has got four properties which will be mapped onto the table employee, and it has got a default constructor and also parameterized constructor. So here is the Hibernate mapping. In this you see the generator class, here it is native, so it will check which it will automatically try to check which particular the underlying database is, and according to its strategy it will apply the ID, okay. And here we are mapping the properties onto the column names, okay, and the data types of each property is being specified, okay. And then let's go to manage employee class. Let's close this too. In this manage employee class, what we are doing is we had first of all created a session factory using this create session factory method. This is our own method, we have created it. You can also put this particular code, you can put this code over here also, no issue in that. Just for understanding, I have made another method, a separate method. Once we call the create session factory, a factory object, session factory object is assigned to this factory. And then what we do is we create an object of this manage employee class so that we can call its add employee method and list employees method. So by calling add employee method, what we are doing is we are creating three objects. And again, we will be putting these objects into the database. By calling this add employee method, we put this objects into the database. Okay, then comes the list employees method. This list employees method will be showing the employees. So what I've done is, what you will do is you can follow the steps that I show you right now. Using the same steps, I have created this Hibernate F1. In the end, I use the word web, so you can identify both. You can also identify or differentiate both from the logo that you are able to see over here. This is a web app. This is a simple Java app. So here, let me show you in this web app. I have not used any JSP or HTML pages, and directly source pages. I have taken this default packages, and in this com package I have taken this manage employee servlet, manage EMP servlet. Instead of, see over here what do we have? Here we have a simple Java file. If I open, that is a simple Java class, manage employee class, whereas here I have converted that class into a servlet, a class that extends a servlet. Okay, and whatever code was there, I've taken it as it is, the same these lines are same as it is in that particular class. It were, instead of main method, I have taken doGet method. In doGet method, first work we have to do is to get the response object, and in this response object set the content type and get the print writer object. And after getting that, what we do is we create a session factory, get a factory object. Once the factory object is initialized, we have to create the objects by saying add employee. So you can see I have not created any object over here because this doGet method will be called only when manage employees, manage em servlet object will be created by the container. So once the object is created, we can directly call this method. So now we don't need to create a new object. Okay, so I simply add a employee over here, and instead of system.out.println, I am simply saying out.println. I am also using break tag so that it gets printed properly. And then you can see this three objects are being added. It returns the integer. Okay, similarly in add employee, the same whole code is as it is. In list employees, only thing that I have changed is this. Instead of system.out.println, I am using out.print and then break tag. So you see there is not much difference in the previous code and this code. Only thing changes is the way of giving the output, that changes. Okay, although current Java versions and current NetBeans versions don't work like this. They are focused on creating Maven applications, and using that Maven applications we have to create a Hibernate based web application. But that thing becomes a very big application. You need to take care of property files and any dependencies and many other things. But right now, what I've done is I've created a simple small application. And first we had created a Hibernate desktop-based application, and now what I've done is converted the same application into web-based application. And yes, over here I've also added the libraries. Hibernate libraries are added, and MySQL JDBC driver library jar file is also added. Okay, so let me run this for you. Before that, let me see whether there is something in the database. An employee, it is empty. Okay, so let's run this for you. I have given this URL as manage. Let's wait, let's see what is happening. It is starting the GlassFish server. It will take some time as the GlassFish server is starting. Okay, that's it. So now let's see what is the output over here. We are adding three objects. Okay, first we are adding three objects and we are printing its employee number. So it will be something like 1, 2, 3 will be printed with this, and then the list of employees will be shown. Yes, so you can see employee number added is 1, then 2, then 3. Then the list of employees is being shown, and after printing each employee, what I have done is, and in this particular list employees method, after printing each employee, I have just added one HR, how.printHR, so that a horizontal rule is put to identify three particular different records. Okay, so okay, so now let me show you how to do that, how to do make this app. Okay, this try to follow this steps. If you have this particular app, Hibernate app 1, if you have downloaded this, you can easily convert it into Hibernate app 1 web.